video on Downeyville, and I was like, Nick, that's where we're at. So, dude, you know what? I'm a man of faith, so I think somebody brought you here. He's got a 350 fuel injected. He's got a brand new one.
This is a 350 fuel injected?
Yeah.
Uh-oh, and?
And it just stopped. It just died. I mean, basically it was riding fine, and, you know, for 7 days, and then all of a sudden...
We were just having this argument on the website about fuel injection versus carburetors.
Yeah. Are you carbureted?
No, I'm fuel injected, 13 yeah. model.
You know, we checked the fuel line, we checked...
Did you replace your filter already?
The filter seems fine. There's plenty of pressure going through there. The fuel pump, I just pulled to make sure we're getting spark.
And it's squirting fuel right out, huh?
Yeah, squirting fuel out. I guess it's possible one of the injectors could be clogged, but, you know, that's something we haven't looked at yet. But everything, all the fuses are fine, everything else seems fine. I'm trying to think of what else could be causing it to go wrong.
And if there's any fuses behind there. Now, did you guys get in at 3 a.m. last night?
Yeah, we did.
Wallace?
We haven't even checked the Facebook page or anything.
Yeah.
Yeah, we were up there on the Heller Creek Trail, and we had gotten hung up a couple of times. We lost my bike. Had to pull it out, and then we'd gone off the trail a couple other times. And we were like, you know what, these are hiking trails, we're having trouble keeping our line.
Yeah.
Let's take the road out.
And it's overgrown.
So we found the road, but then we were working the road, and we worked it probably for 3 hours. We got out on the road.
Yeah.
But we probably had 20, 30 deadfall. We had to go.
Oh, shit. Yeah. So, way off the track, and then there's deadfall. Yeah. Yep. Yeah. Yep. Gotcha.
So,
all right.
That's what happened to us. I don't know.
You guys must be whipped, though, for lack of sleep.
Oh, yeah. We were hosed.
Oh, man. Well, this is going to be some fun. We've hooked up with some other riders here on the last day of the tour of Idaho. Dave and Nick, they're called Team LA. They're serious contenders for the Tour of Idaho to get their numbers. They've done everything right so far. We just changed the spark plug on his fuel-injected brand new 350 EXCF, and he's back in business with a couple of good kickstarts. They thought they were out of the running here at the very end, but they're back in the game. This is the last day. They're gonna try and get it all done today. So I'm gonna go ride with them on the Independence Creek Trail portion here and enjoy the rest of the day. You guys are getting tired, man.
I feel washed out.
Yeah.
That frickin' sand.
Yeah. This is Idaho backcountry airstrip of McGee. Nice grass strip. Looks like easy entry this way, but it looks like the winds are coming this way, prevailing winds. So you can see you got to snake down this canyon to get in here. Ain't sure how long it is. Let's take a look at that. That's pretty short. Yeah, that's pretty short. And the elevation here is, well, 3,200 feet, so that ain't bad. You take off into the wind, got a pretty clear shot at it going down the canyon that way. Nice trip, man. Come back up with a Luscom. Here, let me lead for a while.
Done this twice.
Yeah. That slick snot red shit right there, yeah.
What happened to me earlier?
What'd you guys get, like 3 hours of sleep last night?
Yeah, that's about right.
Because you were up at 6 and going, you got in at 3.
I feel pretty good.
You know, and you did you take a break in after day one?
No.
Oh boy. 7 days of fatigue, man.
Yeah, someone else lead. I'm not at the right spot.
Independence Creek Trail. This is the last great highlight of the Tour of Idaho. We'll be right back. stick in the middle there so you can relax a little bit. I'm slowing down the pace for these guys a little. That helps them reduce mistakes. Do the whole thing, the tour of Idaho in 7 days. Sounds like shit to 5 pounds out.
Water.
up. Yeah, I'm showing up. Climb out of Independence Creek Trail. Creek Trail, I'd say one of the fun bits on the tour of Idaho, one of the crown jewels.
Real gem, yeah.
About that, the one, that little Boulder Creek was probably our favorite. That one was incredible.
Yeah, that one takes the cake, especially for the scenery and those mountains
lake
behind there, whose name I forget. Yeah.
And it's long too. Just go. That's like 25-30 miles.
Yeah. Fantastique. Wow, within 10 miles of Lake Pend'Oreille. I think it means ear ring or ear hang in French. Well, here's where you come out of Independence Creek Trail. It was right there. Very, very cool. Right on my ass. Have you done all 7 days like that? Fuck.
Yeah, we like that kind of riding.
Yeah.
It's fun stuff.
Wow.
That's as good as it gets.
Yep. So this is the famous Ruby Ridge, where all that anti-government showdown activity and what was it? Anybody remember that fella's name? The FBI shot and killed his family. It's happening right up here.
Right. Yeah.
Yep. Right in this neighborhood. Hoodoo Mountain's just right up there. A couple songs written about that too. Yeah. Have to dig that up. Well, I'll tell you a story not long ago. High on a mountain in Idaho. In Idaho. Yeah.
Yeah, I was living free.
Hoodoo.
I sold the song off Shotgun.
Top of Hoodoo Mountain. Major checkpoints for these guys. It's the last one. Go to Alaska! There's where you've been.
Tour of Idaho 2014, Lookout Mountain, overlooking Priest River, way down there, and of course it's sunset now, and we'll head back to the town of Priest River. Team LA made it, 7 days, they're going to get the challenge point and the big prize. What are you going to do now that you finished the Tour of Idaho? No Disneyland? Okay. There it is, Priest Lake, Canada. Beautiful sunset.